Hi, I'm David Cantor with the Law Offices of David Michael Cantor, and today I'm going to talk about myself. People often ask me, why did you go into law? How did you get into criminal defense? And I always take it back to when I was a young kid. My mother and father were both lawyers. My mom was a career prosecutor, and my dad did defense, prosecution, and he was a judge. So they used to get in spirited arguments all the time around the dinner table, and at Thanksgiving we'd have my uncle over, who's also a lawyer. My mother was number two in her class at U of A in law school, and then was number one on the Arizona State Bar and number one on the California Bar. Great intellect. She also was the chief of criminal appeals for the AG's office, the first woman chief of appeals for Arizona. My father, he was a trial attorney. He did over 400 felony jury trials in his career and had great success. I decided I was not going to go into law after hearing the two of them around the dinner table. So I went to ASU and I graduated in 1986 with a psychology degree and a sociology degree. When I came out, I found out there weren't a lot of jobs in those fields, and the job prospects just weren't that good. So I thought, well, I'll go to law school since psychology and sociology are one of the six big pre-law degrees. I took the test, the LSAT, I did well, got into U of A's law school, a top 20 public program. Plus I could afford it since it was in state back then, and I went to law school. While I was there, I did what's called the 38E program, that's student prosecution. I went down to Pima County and I prosecuted DUI jury trials. I did quite a few and I won them all. I thought, hey, I'm pretty good at this. So after law school, I went to the city of Phoenix and I was an assistant city prosecutor. And while I was there, I was trained in HGN, that's horizontal gaze nystagmus, DRE, that's drug recognition evaluation. And I was trained in all these techniques, and I did 30 jury trials while I was there, and I never lost. I was told at the time I was the first and only undefeated prosecutor to leave there. I think that has since been broken, but it was interesting. So I went over with a private defense firm, and I was there for 3.5 years doing the defense side. And while I was there, and granted the defenses were much easier back then, they've eliminated some at this time, but I did 75 jury trials. I averaged 25 a year, and I won about 80% of those jury trials. And by the way, all of those wins are not on our site. I've only put wins on our site since I formed my own firm after leaving that particular law firm. So our 130 complete jury trial acquittals, that means total walk, all charges not guilty, would be a much higher number if I would have included that, but I didn't. I've taught at seminars. I've taught at the Phoenix Police Academy in a mock trial setting to teach police officers. I did the defense side. I've taught at the judicial conference mock trial. Myself and a private defense attorney, at that time I was a prosecutor, we did this in front of 200 judges to show them how a trial should look. I've been speaker at numerous DUI seminars and other seminars. I've taught at the MVD in Arizona. In fact, I even taught in Las Vegas. I did a seminar on child homicide. They tapped me to speak at that conference because I had a capital murder case dismissed outright because the scientific evidence was wrong and that individual never harmed this child, and the entire case was dismissed with prejudice. Now, when I was 35 years old, I did my first double capital murder jury trial. Although I didn't win, I did save that individual's life. He was not given death. Of all the capital murder cases I've had, I've never had anyone sentenced to death, so I've never lost anyone. In 1999, I was made a certified criminal law specialist by the Arizona Board of Legal Specialization. I applied, they vetted me, I took a day-long test, it was graded, and I was tapped in to be a certified criminal law specialist, and I've been one ever since. Our firm has handled numerous cases. We've done homicides, sex crimes, white collar, fraud, theft, drug cases, and of course DUI and vehicular crimes. You name it, we've done it. The average amount of experience is over 10 years for each of the lawyers that works here. That's the average, it's over a decade. So we know what we're doing. As far as our firm library, we have one of the most extensive libraries in the state. We have FBI manuals, we have HGN manuals, DRE manuals, blood spatter, headspace gas chromatography, infrared mass spectrometry, DNA, mitochondrial DNA, trace DNA, you name it, gunshot residue, we've got all of the resources. We also have access to the best experts in the business, some of the best accident reconstruction experts, some of the best black box or statistical and diagnostical module experts when they take that out of your car. Some of the best computer forensic experts that can retrieve data off of cell phones or computers. They can tell if somebody hacked into your computer. Some of the best that exist, we have access. Now people say, David, why do you say you're beyond aggressive? And the reason I say that is back in the 90s, there were all these lawyers saying aggressive, aggressive, aggressive. And I said, if they're aggressive, what am I? And somebody said, well, you're beyond aggressive. And I said, that's exactly what I am and what my staff is. So basically, what that means is we don't just look under all the rocks for defenses. We think of new rocks to look under. We think of everything. So if there's any way out of the charge, either factual, technical, we're going to find it, use it to your advantage. Now, as I said, we have over 130 complete jury trial acquittals on our site, dmcantor.com. We have over 3,000 total wins on our site of all different types. Go to our site and check it out. Now, if you call us to make an appointment and come in and see us, it doesn't cost you anything. We're going to give you 30 minutes of our time. So it'll eat up 30 minutes of your time, but it won't cost you a dime. So give us a call if you or a loved one's been charged. I look forward to hearing from you soon.